How much stress do temperature changes put on structures? Are some materials more resistant than others? And how are things built to protect against thermal effects? Let's take a concrete beam, a steel beam, and a wood beam, and see how they react to thermal stress. Each beam will be 10 meters long, and we'll start the temperature at minus 10 Celsius, then crank it up to plus 40 Celsius. First, we'll check how much each beam expands. Then, we'll constrain all the beams and see how stressed each one becomes from the temperature change. In order to run this analysis, we need a couple simple equations from beam theory. The first shows us how temperature change affects length. The change in length is simply the original length, times temperature change, times a factor called the thermal expansion coefficient, which is different for every material. This number is usually around 1 to 50 out of 1 million. The second equation can tell us how much stress is caused in the beam if this change in length is constrained, which will depend on how stiff the material is.
More on that later.
Returning to our model and applying the plus 50 degree increase in temperature, we see each beam expand. The concrete expands 5 millimeters, the steel 5.5 millimeters, and the wood 2.5 millimeters. The difference in expansion of each material is due to each having a different thermal expansion coefficient, which can be plotted here for comparison to many other materials. Concrete and steel have similar coefficients, which is one of the many reasons that make reinforced concrete such a useful composite. The value for wood should be caveated, though, since wood experiences much more change in length due to absorbing moisture from the air than it does from changes in temperature directly. Let us know if that topic interests you, and we can work on a video for that too. Now, what happens if we constrain the beams instead of allowing them to expand? In this case, instead of the thermal energy converting to a change in length, it will cause internal stresses in each of the beams. The amount of internal stress will be different for each beam too. The stress is much higher in the steel, because steel is very stiff. So that means even a small amount of strain or deformation could correspond to a very large force. Steel is about 10 times stiffer than concrete, and about 25 times stiffer than wood. However, each of these materials have different strengths as well, so we can check how much of the strength is used up by this constrained thermal stress. As the numbers show, the constrained beams use up a significant portion of the strength, between about 15 and 40%. Of course, we have to keep in mind that beams and other structures are rarely fully restrained in reality, and the thermal movements have to go somewhere. Best to ensure that elements are designed keeping in mind where the movements are allowed to be, or they can show up where not desired and cause cracking, buckling, or failure. Everyday life has plenty of familiar examples of thermal movement joints, in sidewalks, on bridges, and even tucked away where windows are framed into walls. Examples of issues due to thermal movement are commonplace too, from oil canning on metal facades, to cracked concrete or asphalt, and even damage to roof finishes. Additionally, most primary structural members are protected by the building enclosure, and being insulated reduces the magnitude of thermal effects. Some structures aren't practical to be enclosed, though, such as transportation or industrial infrastructure, so particular care should be taken in these cases when structures are exposed to large temperature ranges. We limited our review to temperature effects only here, but it's important to keep in mind that temperature change generally also involves moisture or humidity change, too. The flow of moisture, whether through condensation, freeze-thawing, or other hygroscopic processes, also has very significant impact on structures. Let us know if there are similar thermal issues or solutions that you're familiar with. We read every single comment, and we always enjoy reading your suggestions for video topics. We're a small creator, just two friends who like to nerd out making videos, so we really appreciate when you like, subscribe, and turn on notifications for our channel. Feel free to buy us a coffee at the link below too. Cheers, and see you next time.